Hi guys, this is Matthias, and in this video I would like to talk to you about Manfred von Richthofen, also known as the Red Baron. Now this is a legend among fighter pilots, probably the most respected and recognized ace that has ever lived. All in all, the Red Baron has been credited with 80 confirmed victories, this while serving in the German army in World War I. Now throughout his career, Richthofen flew a variety of different planes, and the Albatross D3 that you will see in this video is only one of them. He also flew the earlier model of the Albatross, which was the D2, as well as the Halberstadt D2, and the plane that he is probably most known for and most associated with, the Fokker DR1 triplane. Richthofen was born the 2nd of May, 1892, and he actually joined the German army as a cavalryman, but in 1915 he transferred to the air service, becoming one of the first members of Jasta II in 1916. This happened after he met with Oswald Bulke, who not only taught Richthofen, but who Richthofen also continued to idolize even long after he surpassed him in total victories. Richthofen was known as a very tactical pilot, a trait that probably was much his own, but was most likely also strengthened by Bulke, who definitely was considered an air combat tactician. Several other pilots in this era has actually been described as more acrobatic and perhaps even more skilled.
Oh shit, so many unseen.
Yeah, a few. Now instead of using aggressive and risky tactics like, for example, his brother Lothar, who actually was credited with 40 victories, Manfred followed the tactical rules made by Bulke, also known as Dicta Bulke. And this is something that I have actually covered on this channel, and if you want to see that, there will be a link in the description. Okay, get fucking wrecked. Oh, we need to hold on D. Funny how I have a death also already.
Yeah, we have half a team in the fort, that's why we...
Oh yeah, we're losing the whole because, yeah, everyone's camping the fort, yeah. Also worth knowing about the World War I was that fighter pilots were flying in squadrons. And Jasta II, which I mentioned earlier, was the first squadron that Manfred von Richthofen was a member of. But in 1917, he actually became the leader of Jasta 11. Shortly thereafter, Jasta 11 was combined with Jasta 4, 6 and 10, with the Red Baron as commanding officer. Together, they were commonly known as the Flying Circus. Now, for the most part, the way that the Red Baron scored his victories was by diving down from high altitude and shooting down the enemy plane that was more or less a defenseless target. As a matter of fact, in a lot of cases, they were defenseless targets, because many of the planes that the Red Baron and his wingmen shot down was reconnaissance planes, and they were not even fit for combat at all. But on November the 23rd of 1916, he came across Major Leno Hawker, a British ace pilot, that resulted in a prolonged dogfight that eventually led to Richthofen getting the upper hand. But once getting the upper hand, both his machine guns jammed, leading to an even longer fight, until von Richthofen was able to fix the weapons and finally shoot Hawker down. Von Richthofen later described Hawker as the British Bulke. So after this experience, Richthofen was convinced that he needed a plane with more maneuverability. This even if he had to sacrifice speed. While fighting Hawker, Richthofen was flying an Albatross D2. how this plane was superior to the plane that Hawker was flying, which was an Aerico DH-2 and was considered obsolete. But despite having the superior plane, the Red Baron was still struggling to take Hawker down, mainly because of Hawker's flying technique and experience, and a skill that might even surpass the Red Baron's himself. Get fucking wrecked! Now on the 28th of October 1916, the German Air Force and Richthofen himself suffered a major loss. Richthofen followed his friend and mentor Bulke together with another ace, Erwin Böhme, and three other pilots in a flight that resulted in a dogfight where Bulke and Böhme, unaware of each other's presence, started chasing the same plane. This resulted in a quite soft mid-air collision that damaged the upper wing of Bulke's plane. Now he was able to crash land in a way that seemed like it was going to be survivable. Unfortunately, he was rushed into his plane and before taking off, he didn't strap on his safety belt properly, which is believed to be the unfortunate reason why he died at the age of 25 after 40 aerial victories. Böhme, who blamed himself for Bulke's death, had to actually be talked out of committing suicide. Now, during World War I, the pilots from all nations had their planes not only upgraded, but also replaced with better models. And as much as the Red Baron many times were flying the superior fighter plane, in 1917 this would change when he and his crew encountered a squadron of the new British Sopwith triplane. Now, the German fighter pilots had been warned about this new British plane, and Richthofen knew that this plane was superior to his own in every way. Now, despite that, and despite the fact that when they encountered the enemies had higher altitude, leaving them with yet even another advantage, Richthofen still decided to engage the enemy. Also worth knowing is that at this point in time, the Albatross that Richthofen was flying had a design flaw, making its lower wing vulnerable in critical maneuvers. This is something that had killed several German pilots in the past, and even Richthofen had earlier been forced to make an emergency landing based on this flaw. Shortly after the attack from the triplanes, Richthofen found himself chasing one of the British planes. Knowing that he had no chance of catching up with the British plane he was chasing, he started shooting at him, even though he was well out of range. Now, the British pilot reacted by making evasive maneuvers, something that slowed him down. Now, Richthofen, who keeps his plane flying straight forward, eventually gets within 50 yards of the British plane and shoots him down. This happens in the same day that he has already shot down three planes earlier, making this the fourth kill in one single day. Now, on the 6th of July 1917, Richthofen gets severely injured. This happens while in combat with an FE-2D, which is a two-seat plane, and this plane actually shot at Richthofen while being well out of range. However, one of the bullets hits the Red Baron in the head, making him disoriented, and he also temporarily and partly gets blind. Richthofen will never truly recover from this injury. Now he's able to emergency land in friendly territory, and after several operations, he returns to active duty 19 days later, this against the doctor's orders. Now the injury caused not only headache, but also nausea. Despite this, the Red Baron continued to fly and continued scoring victories until the 21st of April 1918. This day, while following a Sopwith Camel on low altitude, he was attacked by another Sopwith Camel, this while flying over enemy troops. Now, it is believed that the bullet that actually killed the Red Baron was fired from the ground. This based on the angle of the fatal wound, and also the fact that the Red Baron was able to stay alive for 2 minutes after being attacked by the enemy plane. Now, by 1918, Richthofen had become such a legend that his superiors wanted him grounded. He was a hero, and they feared that if he would be killed, this would be a major blow to the German morale. Richthofen wouldn't hear of it. He considered it his duty to continue to fly, just like every poor fellow in the trenches endured their duty. Now, if the Red Baron is something that interests you and you want to know more about him or see some movies about him, there is plenty to choose from. Now this video, on the other hand, is from a round of Conquest where I was able to get 85 kills, leaving me with the best score I've got so far playing this game mode. Now I'm going to let you see the rest of the video, and before I end the post commenting, I just want to say this. Manfred Albrecht Freiherr von Richthofen, may you always be remembered. My name is Matthias, and I want to thank you all for watching. Anti-air! The anti-air is real! Return to the combat area. He asked his team to... Oh, is that they want to kill me? Is that what he said, T2non?
Uh-huh.
Free translator.
DS?
No, I don't, CS. I don't know what language it is, but...
Russian, probably.
Yeah.
With those signs. Russian or Greek or whatever. Oh shit, then fuck.
that thing works every time. Can you get anti-air on the fortress? I'm gonna mark it actually. My farm is over now because of the fucking fortress there.
No, I couldn't.
Dictator Putler, I'm not sure if I killed the anti-air there. There was more than one guy there. I could have, but I could have not. Yeah, I'm marking A. Oh, there was no one on anti-air, what the fuck? Killed a few guys by A.
Guys, yeah, the camp is out there. Good job.
Onu gördünüz mü? Onların askerlerinden biri. We have lost objective Duff.
We have lost objective George. Halfway there, we have the what? How is it that those people keep spawning planes? I don't get it. So unexpected. Go about the 80k deer. It's gonna be hard since I was killed once. Or that's a death from the former round. No flags. Really, a team. We have G. Seriously, all these kills I'm getting, I'm like a behemoth for our team, and we have one flag.
Yeah.
Okay, go for D. We almost started taking, yeah. Let's see, oh, we're taking E, nice.
We have taken objective Duff.
Taking E, probably, maybe, perhaps. Titunon! Was that the guy who was speaking to me in Russian, or speaking in Russian?
Oh.
I think it was.
What's that?
I'm not sure, but I think so. Oh, Ribbon of Icarus. You still, yeah, you're right, KD, you're right. Yeah, 80 is what we're going for because of what's his name? The actual Red Baron. Manfred von Richthofen. Anti-air from... that's gotta be... G. Yeah, G anti-air. Marking G.
Canyon C. Wow, team, come on! Our fucking... wake up! Hasım askeri, o tarafta! Şu Allah'ın belası hedefi ele geçirin!
Sure, you can kill it out of... gambling. Oh, I hear a plane. G, what are these guys? There's four guys that I could just go and get. G, what the hell?
Bir düşman askerine doğru bakıyorum.
Ah, he was already dead. We're getting G. Alright, that's about time.
Şu Allah'ın belası hedefi ele geçirin.
We're losing even D.
Yeah, D. There's two guys on D only.
Look at our teammates. They're all between C and D, but there is no one on C or on D.
Yeah. I've marked it so they could easily get it, but...
hedef şu, ele geçirin. Hedefi ele geçirin.
The Red Baron to the rescue. Bad weather, I can't see my kills. Ah, there was a few.
Tank görüldü. Tetikte olun.
We should probably... Okay, are we getting E? No.
Hedef şu. Ele geçirin.
Oh, we're getting D.
Şurada hasım askeri.
Tismo, thank you for following, and Jedori, thank you for following.
Hedefi ele geçirin. Hedefi müdafaa edin.
We have taken objective Duff.
There's some guys halfway up towards D.
All right.
Hedefi fethedin.
You should go for C actually, but I'm marking F anyway. Oh baby, a triple! Hey, Alfred von Richthofen, here I come. Oh, Manfred von Richthofen, I mean, not Alfred. No! Stop shooting me with anti-air, for fuck's sake, I need one more kill. Pew pew. I'll give you permission to drink one beer.
Anti-vehicle kit is available near your location.
Get fucking wrecked!
Objective Edward.
Bu hedefi zapt edemeyecekler. Müdafaa edin!
No.
What a team.
Pew pew.